first thing I want to hit is the issue of the killings of the innocent people. From here to here, you hear of people killing people. Why should somebody who is a Nigerian get up and kill a fellow Nigerian for nothing? And nobody is saying anything. Everybody is silent.
Yeah. Government is
right.
Silent.
When something like that will happen over there in the foreign country, our nation, our government will now go and compensate them and begin to say apologies. But it's happening here. Nobody cares. Our own blood, is it not human blood? Mm. Are we animals?
No.
My people, are we animals?
No.
We are humans. And yes. Therefore, any right we should take it. This is our right. It's our right to live as Nigerians. Whether we are educated or not, whether we are rich or not, whether we are beautiful or handsome or not, all we know is that God has given us Nigeria as our home. And Nigeria will remain our
home.
Okay, one advice I want to give to Nigerian leaders is that, see, one of the core problems of Nigeria or Africans at large is selfishness. If Nigeria will keep away selfishness and believe that we can do it without our own selfish interest, Nigeria will become the best nation of the world. Leader must be a what? A servant. So we want servant leaders in Nigeria.
Yes.
Not without
leaders. Lastly, do you think that this actualizing a nation that we want in this country will only be realized only through our leaders? Do you think there's going to be something like collective efforts towards actualization?
Okay, that's it. We believe that our leaders are the ones who are holding the head of the group. And if the Igbo people will always say that, have you seen it? So we who are Nigerians, who are the citizens of Nigeria, we want to show the government that we want them to change. Let them begin it. They are talking about change. But we have not seen anything changing. Everything is even changing to worse. Are you getting it? So let them first of all show this the example. Let them show it by leadership, or by example of what they want to do. If they see it now and show it, we all will now follow. We are meant to be followers. We are not going to be leaders. We are the ones who are following. But when the leaders is not leading us right, it is our right to say we don't want the way you are leading us.
Yes.
My name remains Reverend Moses Nnedi for Ekachi. Thank you. And I go back and ever.
Nigeria is a blessed country. Nigeria is a very blessed country.
Yes, yes.
But like my colleague has said, we have problems with leadership and mismanagement of resources.
Oh yes.
Nigeria is a country that, when you call the top 20 nations of the world, we should be included. But what do we have? We have corruption. And this thing is not going to allow us to reach our peak. We have everything it takes. Like, Nigeria is so blessed. You know Malaysia, you know today, was built from our own palm oil. Like they came to Nigeria, they got our palm
oil.
Our Aku. They got it and then they did billions, they made what they fact everything they have today is basically from that. Now Dubai back in the day, they had the gold and everything. They came to America, they wanted loans and everything. But they had intellect, they went back. They ripped their gold and everything, and then they did a lot. We have oil, but we don't have good refineries. We have oil, yes, we give it to the people out there. They refine for us, and then they give us our own property. They just tell us how much they're going to sell to us, and we just have to take it. But then we produce the richest man in Africa. But what is he doing? I don't know. That's to show you that Nigeria has potential. But we have problems. We're all youths. But we are not being like the government doesn't support us on. Yet our president would rather say we are lazy. And he's not going to help us. We have rain. We're suffering from rain in Nigeria. You see, everyone here wants to leave the shores of Nigeria because out there, even in the face of racism and racial discrimination, there's still mention because the economy is booming. You see, Nigeria has a lot of work to do. We need to get on our feet. We need to do what we have to do to make Nigeria
Bam.
No to hardship, bro.
We are this country. We are suffering. We can hardly eat 1 million.
Let's see your black. Ah,
security
brutal.
Security brutals. Security brutalists.
No hardship. No hardship.
I want a better
country. We are the
best. Yes, we will.
Onye Izugbo, and I'm an indigenous of Anambra, as you can see. I am here to. I don't know if you're seeing this. We are actually tired of hardship here in Nigeria. Every year we complain of a recession in our economy. Despite the fact that we have so many minerals and so many things that we can actually use to make Nigeria a better place, but our major problem, as my colleague have said here, is leadership.
Yes.
And our leaders are really doing nothing, practically nothing, about the welfare and the development of Nigeria as a country. You can see my colleagues here. You can see demanding for so many things, and we are just here for a peaceful and a peaceful agitation. A peaceful rally to show how unpleased and how tired we are of the situation of the country. You can see how much everybody here is agitated.
All right,
thank you.
Go ahead.
My name is Ikechukwu Nelson, and I'm here this evening to protest against this low standard of living in Nigeria. We are tired of low standard of living,
yes.
Poor academic utilities.
Yes.
We are tired of all the killings that are happening in Nigeria. We are tired of poor conditions of living. They can imagine that an average Nigerian cannot boast of $1 per day. It is a very preposterous and very
absurd
and highly dishumanizing. And we are here to say no to all this. People are dying every day, nobody's saying anything. People are being killed by even our security agencies, and nobody's saying anything. People are dying for accidents, and nobody's saying anything.
Because of bad
people news. Are dying, and nobody's saying anything.
Why?
We are pleading, and we are begging. We are the youths, and we know how it feels. They say that we are the leaders of tomorrow, and tomorrow is today. And we are believing and begging them to please come to our aid.
Help us.
Suffering. The students are suffering, the workers are suffering, the poor masses are suffering. Why some few are enjoying and the majority are suffering?
Oh,
so, and we are here today to say please. We are here today to beg them, please, to help us.
Poor are the rich, which are only in Nigeria.
Tell them, because that we are begging them now to help us.
Please.
Because it is the time for us to enjoy the things.
Dividend of democracies.